Okay, I figured I'd do a little video on this shotgun here. I've had it for quite a long time. I think I got it for like $70 years ago. It's a CIL 402, but you can find the Remington ones. And they're all made by CBC in Brazil. And they come in several gauges. This one's a 12 gauge, it's a 30 inch full choke, this one. And they're quite fairly common. They're a really nice, robust gun. They kind of remind me of like the Tramontina from Brazil, like they're the machete from Brazil. They're sort of a common man, but they're a working gun. They work fairly well. Like they're fairly robust. Like everything is fairly heavy duty on the thing, other than like the plastic bits and stuff. But it's only really an issue like in cold weather. Just an auto eject, empty shell here. And it does throw the casing pretty good. And it's a rebounding hammer, you can carry it safely. But quite common in Canada, and I don't know, they're not bad guns or anything. I kind of like it. Machete, you got some corned beef from Brazil, and then we got some Magtech or the CBC shotgun shells made by the same people. I guess they were owned by Remington and like Imperial Chemical or something for several years. That's what the internet says, anyway. I think they're their own company again. I do have some 7.62, well, it's kind of NATO ammo, but it's stuff that was made by CBC back in the 70s as well. But it was like, then it was reloaded by somebody else later. But this one's in pretty good shape. A lot of times they're kind of beat up, but this one's got a bit of that freckling or whatever on the finish. But I don't think the bluing was that deep to start with, like it was fairly thin. But it says 12 gauge, 2¾ inch full. And it has written on the other side, made in Brazil by Company Brasilia de Cartucho. And they're in, is it San Paulo, wherever you pronounce that. It's in southern Brazil. And I guess this wood, they call it like Brazilian walnut, but if you look it up on the internet, it's a tree that's not related to walnut, but I guess it's one of the harder hardwoods or something that they got in Brazil that actually can make stuff out of, or I believe that's what this is. But it's not a bad looking piece of wood. It's got a few knots and stuff in it, but pretty good for like what these guns cost. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys. So maybe we'll have the shooting video sometime if the range opens. But anyway, talk to you later.